Well, it's safe to say the sales have certainly taken off here at the Riverside Complex this afternoon. And joining me now is Australia Prince Royal Coolmore, Tom Magnier. Good afternoon to you, Tom. I tell you what a fantastic atmosphere we have here at Inglis today.
Yeah, it's been a long time in between drinks. Obviously, for the last 2 years, we haven't been able to have anyone from internationally back in Sydney or the Gold Coast. So it's really good to see people from all over the world, from Japan, from Ireland, from America. They're all here because, you know, what's happening in Australia on the racetracks and, you know, in the breeding barns and on the world stage, it's where everybody wants to be right now.
Just in your words and the conversations that you're having with those overseas, what is the industry like here at the moment? How well is it performing?
It's the best in the world, and everybody around the world is jealous. Prize money in Australia is through the roof. You know, you can buy a horse with your friends here, buy a horse for 200,000, and you run in races that are worth 150. There's 70 races worth over $1 million now, and you know you're paying, you know, 200,000 for these horses, and you go to trainers, you go in with your best mates, and listen, you have a great day out. And, you know, you have a chance of getting a champion and winning a lot of prize money. You get home and your wife or your husband, they won't be cross.
I know you're at me to get shopping today, and I could be in a whole lot of trouble if I do. Let's take a look at a couple of the lots that you've purchased today, lot 90 and lot 91. Talk us through those two colts.
Yeah, we bought Snitzel from Arrowfield for 1.4. Snitzel's obviously four-time champion sire. He's a really good-looking horse. All the best judges on the week were on him. We've got a colt syndicate with Chris Waller. We all really like this horse. So when you find one here in Sydney at this sale, when you've got the best pedigrees, you really have to put your shoulders back and to go to prices like that to 1.4. And I think it's going to be like that all week.
And of course, the I'm Invincible went for $1 million. Are we going to see a bit of a home affairs situation there? Are you going to try and chase another home affairs?
Yeah, but that's what's good about Australian racing. You know, like we went and we bought Home Affairs. He won two Group 1s recently, and now he's going off to Royal Ascot in a couple of weeks' time, where, you know, hopefully we put these Australian horses on the map. I think he'd be hard to beat up there. So listen, when you buy a horse like that, that's the dream, that you get another Home Affairs.
Of course, we were lucky enough to go to Coolmore recently and have a look at some of your yearlings there. Your draft is looking absolutely spectacular. The team must be full of confidence.
Yeah, very happy. We've had a couple of horses go through already that have made a lot of money. And we've some horses that are going through this evening that'll be very popular. You know, all the top trainers are here, your Gay Waterhouses, your Peter Moody's, your Chris Wallers. They're all here and they like the draft. They're very happy with what they see. So, and they've got plenty of orders. So listen, it's a very healthy, vibrant market at the moment. So long may it last.
It is also a wonderful social outing. So if you haven't been to the Inglis Easter Yearling Sales before, come on down. It is only day one here. And of course, we'll have all your coverage right across the next couple of days right here on Sky News.